you, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Warren Zevon. We are going to react to the song Keep Me In Your Heart. This is the first time that we are going to listen to Warren Zevon, going to react to Warren Zevon and this song. This is requested by our patron David B. And I like the title of the song already, Keep Me In Your Heart.
Yeah, it's quite emotional.
It is.
The title itself is so emotional. It sounds like or seems like it's going to be a song about someone who's leaving.
Saying goodbye.
Yeah.
Here on Enoma, we give first time single take honest reaction. When we say honest, we really mean it. When we like a song, we talk about what all are the things that connected with us, what all things that we liked about it. Sometimes, you know, we react to about 200 songs a month. And not all the songs that come for our reaction, we can like. It's natural. Some of the songs are there that we don't connect with, and especially certain topics may be in the songs that we don't relate to, being from our background, being from India, being for who we are, two different people. It may be the best choice or the best song for the person who requests, but it doesn't have to be one of the best songs that we come across.
And that is what is our speciality.
That's that what is about people.
Two easygoing native outsiders living in Mumbai, India, looking at music, listening to it from a third person's point of view. Someone who's not a fan, someone who's not a part of the team, part of the band. We look at it from an outsider's point of view. That's who we are.
Yeah.
We've never been shy of mentioning it. Our full form of Enoma is easygoing native outsiders making assessments. That's who we are. We are proud of that and we love listening to music from all over the world without discrimination. But obviously, since we are from India, there are certain concepts, themes, topics which just don't go down well with us, and some that connect with us instantly. And we enjoy the music, we enjoy the words in the song, we enjoy everything about it. We connect with the voices, and that's so beautiful. But there are times, of course, like Kirti said, we don't connect.
Yeah.
As much as you would like us to.
You know, there are topics
it's just that... It's a review at the end
yeah.
of the day.
There are also certain topics about something about pro-suicide, we don't connect. And I don't think that stance is ever going to change. There are certain things about drugs and drug-related, especially when it is not anti-drug and it is about it or for it.
And glorifying the use of
it. We won't be ever going that far.
Anyway, this one may be something down our alley.
Yeah.
Keep me in your heart. As counselors, as a married couple, as parents, this is something that I think, if it's about what I think it is, it is very easy for us to connect with it. So let's see what Kirti has to say about it as a pure reactor, and perhaps I will chip in too. For David B.
Are falling and I'm running out of breath. Keep me in your heart for a while. If I leave you, it doesn't mean I love you any less. Keep me in your heart for a while. When you get up in the morning and you see that crazy sun, keep me in your heart for a while. There's a train leaving nightly called when all is said and done. Keep me in your heart for a while. Sha-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Keep me in your heart for a while. Sometimes when you're doing simple things around the house, maybe you'll think of me and smile. You know I'm tied to you, back the buttons on your blouse. Keep me in your heart for a while. Hold me in your thoughts. Take me to your dreams. Touch me as I fall into view. When the winter comes, keep the fires lit, and I will be right next to you. Engine drivers headed north to Pleasant Street. Keep me in your heart for a while. These wheels keep turning, but they're running out of steam. Keep me in your heart for a while. Sha-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Keep me in your heart for a while. Sha.
I'll try to look up if he's alive or dead, because I got the sense that perhaps he's passed away.
Okay, the singer.
So I couldn't find out, so perhaps if you can find it out quickly, because you're much better at all these things on the phone at least.
Mm-hmm.
So this was so heartfelt, this was so beautiful. What a voice, he just has a magnific, as they say in French. Wow, what a beautiful, magnificent voice. Just so wonderful to listen to him. Easy listening at its best. Just so beautiful. You know, the line coming in again and again. Keep me in your heart for a while. Just so profound, just so beautiful. It says it all. And then there's so much substance to back it up. We do get many song requests where that substance is lacking. They are just repeated lines, repeated lines, repeated lines. Here the same line is repeated many times. But along with that, every line that comes before it is so deep, so profound, so meaningful, and you can connect with it in some way or another. You can instantly connect with it, especially if you are a married couple, if you are in love, if you are in a intense or a serious relationship. This is something you immediately connect with. It was so beautifully written. I'm assuming this song was written just before he may have passed away, or he knew he was going to pass away. If it's a real life experience.
He has passed away, by the way, yeah. In the year 2003.
So I'm assuming this song was released sometime before
maybe
that.
Maybe to leave it behind.
Yeah, to leave it for his spouse, partner, you know. Or loved ones, kids, etc., if he had them.
Yeah.
So this is so heartfelt. I could connect with it. It seems like it's for a partner or spouse. But, I mean, it is, anyone could connect with it who's in love. And, you know, who's passing away on their deathbed, or who has a terminal illness especially. You know, I mean, the thing with cancer is that I have a lot of experience in it since my father had it, brain cancer. As well as I watched a movie, two movies very recently. One of them is 50-50, mm-hmm. And one is Ordinary Love.
Okay.
Ordinary Love is very fresh in my memory because it just was a couple of days ago. I watched it at the Mumbai International Film Festival.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Liam Neeson is there, the Jurassic Park guy, as well as Commuter and many other movies. Very big actor.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, when you have a terminal, did he die of cancer?
That I didn't check, I can.
Okay.
I can look.
So, especially when you have cancer, I've seen it with my dad, I've seen it in these movies. You know you're about to die, and it's, you know, the stress of that is by itself so demanding at times. You know, there's the pain of chemotherapy specifically, as well as the other drugs or medications you are on, depending what kind of cancer you have. But apart from that, you know, the stress of knowing, especially if it's in the final stages or it's terminal, the stress of knowing that you'll be passing away soon, never to spend time with your loved ones again, never to be there with them, never to talk to them, listen to them, communicate, you kind of realize what life is about. I'm very grateful in a way to these movies, as well as the final years of my father. I learned so much, because had I not had that experience with him in the final years of being close to him, I would not realize the value of life. You know, these kind of movies, these experiences, of course I've read a lot about it as a counselor too, but reading is one thing and experiencing it and seeing it is another. So yeah,
I don't know why your guess, what is with your guess, but your guess is correct. He was diagnosed with cancer almost towards the end of his life in the year 2002. The fact is, that's the first line written over here. He had a lifelong phobia of doctors, and he seldom visited one. He never wanted to consult a doctor. So towards the end, he felt dizzy and he was coughing somewhere outside at an appearance or something like that, and he visited his dentist, because I think that's a regular thing everyone has to go through in most Western countries. I think that's not okay. A criteria in India though, and his dentist insisted that he should visit a physician, and when he visited one, he was diagnosed with some lung related cancer. And I think 2003, he passed away.
May his soul rest in peace, R.I.P. as it's always said.
September 7th.
You know, apart from this, even if I didn't know this, knowing it obviously makes it so much more relevant and meaningful and brilliant, you know, this song. But even if I didn't know how he died or if he was dead or alive, this is a great song. Because it captures those dying moments of someone so vividly. You know, you can connect with it. I instantly could connect with it because of my dad, as well as my mom, though she didn't die of cancer. But similar, you know, I mean, towards the end, I have kind of felt that connection and felt the same pain, what she felt. I could sense this in her, you know, these words. She would probably say it to all of us if she could. Towards the final stages, the last few days I'm talking about. It wasn't too long, the last few days. With my dad, it lasted for a few years. So we did know and we had that time. You know, it's something beautiful about it in this adversity is that when it's a terminal illness, you know. And that knowledge of knowing that you're about to die, it does make a huge difference. It does make a huge difference to you. If you are the one dying, as well as to those who you love and care about, you can get so much done when you know. You know, otherwise you live your life aimlessly. Many of us, now like for me today, I'm blessed to be pretty healthy. I do have a few problems like diabetes and blood pressure, but not something that is terminal right now or very soon. Unless I goof up or I get wounded or something and it doesn't heal quickly enough. The fact is, or if I get a heart attack, obviously, because of high blood pressure or something, or a stroke. The fact is that, you know, when you know, it is stressful, but at the same time, there is some comfort for your loved ones.
Yeah.
You know, when the loved one hears this, it's very comforting. You know, okay, this is going to happen then. I have so much time. And you make the most of that time. And in doing so with my dad, what I remember is when we did that, actually his life was extended. You know, people said he would die in 2 months. He went beyond a year. So that is mainly because of obviously his fighting spirit and his spirit to live and enjoy life in his final stages, but also because You know, we just wanted to have fun. We didn't see it as, oh, he's dying, so be miserable about it. So, this is a great song. What are your thoughts, Kirti?
First and foremost, I enjoyed his voice. That senior voice, that experienced and mature voice as it was coming. Wow, that was beautiful. That was beautiful. It's a great song to listen to. I know it's very sad, it's melancholic, and you know, it may make you feel a bit low. When you're listening to at a moment when actually you're fearing for someone going, or you're thinking someone you might be losing soon, if that kind of scenario is there. But those lines are beautiful. The way he infused the kind of feelings he has at the moment and what he would desire after he's gone as well. Both are two different things, but they are both put together very beautifully. As if it's side of the same coin. I'm feeling breathless, shadows are coming down. There is a train, nightly train that is called All Said and Done or something like that. That was very thoughtfully put there. You know, each line, there was one thing that he was thinking about or he was experiencing at the moment. The kind of awareness that he had that he's probably leaving this world. It's going to somewhere north and this and that. I'm leaving, he's telling. And at the same time, he's giving all those things that don't worry. Keep me in your heart for some time. I'll be there during winter. Please light the fire. I might come and sit next to you. If you are working in the house, would you try and remember me? Or have some memories? And we all have some memories. Every single day when we do some chores at home, we come across belongings of that person, the things that are left behind, the clothes, the things that they used to be fond of, the things that they used to use, the chair they used to mostly sit in at the dining table or in the living room. The bed they used for sleeping, all of those things is just painful, especially in the first few months or almost a year, until you start living with the fact that they are absent. They are absolutely absent, and this is what we have to live with. So I liked his voice, that pain, that kind of, you know, the heaviness in the voice was amazing. And with that guitar playing, it was phenomenal.
Definitely, that is what he's talking about. What you raised over the points you were mentioning, especially the one where after a while you realize, you know, that the person isn't there anymore.
Yeah.
This is what he's talking about. That keep me in your heart for a while.
For some time, yeah.
Yeah, don't just,
you know, just move on.
And it's important, you know, because today's world, this century, this generation, we kind of move on too quickly.
We have ADHD, all of us.
We move on too quickly. We definitely need a song like that, a reminder from a loved one that, you know, keep me in your heart for a while. Because if we don't say that, the person will not remember. And I've personally seen it in my professional as well as personal experience. I've seen a lot of people who do this, who move on too quickly. Mm-hmm. And I often think of telling them this proverb, what goes around comes around. So, you know, if you do that to your loved one, you forget them too soon, chances are your kids, whoever else is there around you, your loved ones, when you also go or it's time to leave, they will also forget about you very quickly. It's a strange thing. This is a very strange but very strong phenomena. What goes around comes around.
Yeah.
And that's why it's important, you know, to... One thing is that while you're alive, make the most of your time.
Yeah.
Obviously, not songs wait, that constantly reminds me and my father's death due to cancer, constantly reminds me, and movies like Ordinary Love and 50-50, constantly remind me that, hey, you're not going to be around for too long. You know, especially if you're like me, 40s, early 40s, you're not in the best of health, you know, compared to some others who are in the 40s. You know, obviously you think about it. It's not that you're going to be around forever or even maybe 30, 40 years. It may happen that you live till 70, 80, but that would be expecting too much. You can pray for it, and I do at times, but will it happen? That's a different story. The fact is, these songs, these kind of things remind me that life is not forever. Make the most of the now, cherish the ones you love. Cherish the things you love. Do what you love. You know, don't waste your time on things that you don't connect with and don't have a strong meaning. You know, they don't give you, you don't have an attachment to it, you don't have a strong connection with it, don't do it. Because we are not going to be around forever. You might as well spend that time on your own. That's what I love to do. Earlier, I used to not do it. You talk about 12 years ago, I myself would not do this. I would spend a lot of time on activities which weren't fruitful in any way to me or my future. In fact, it was ruining my future. You know, for example, I would drink with friends. I would drink, and very frequently. So that definitely shortened my lifespan. If I hadn't done that, and sometimes passive smoke, you know, when you are in Mumbai in a crowded bar, no matter what you do, you also take in passive smoke. Yeah, not that bad though, but sometimes you do get a lot of passive smoke, which you would not get if you were sitting at home, relaxing with the family, with on your own. So these days, whenever I think of those back then, I said, I wish I could have done meditation as I do today. Today, if I have nothing better to do, I meditate. I go to sleep. I do nothing. So that comes because of songs like these, which tell you the importance of life and treasuring all the things which are so important in life. If something is not important, don't do it. Don't waste your time on it, because it is a waste of time. That's obviously my personal view. That's what I've learned the hard way. You know, definitely looking back, I've learned it the hard way. I would have loved to spend more time with my father and mother. Both of them are not with me today, and I realized it far too late. With my dad, as I said, I did have the time because of knowing well in advance that this is going to happen. But with my mom, it didn't happen that way. And unfortunately, by then I was already living with Kirti, as well as the kids had come by then. So it was difficult to, you know, move back and go back and live with my mom. So that made it even more stressful for me at times, thinking about that. But the fact is, when you know, it's comforting. So I like this. Keep me in your heart for a while. That's about it for this one. Anything you'd like to add, Kirti?
No, I'm good. I'm good.
This is a 10.5 on 10 song.
Wow. Yeah.
I don't want to cut anything. I want to add more. 10.5 on 10. In fact, the lyrics, I'll give it 12 on 10. I would have given it 13 on 10, but I'll give it 12 because that one line coming again and again.
Yeah.
But it's backed up so beautifully with substance that I have to still give it more than what I'm supposed to. What about you, Kirti?
For me, I'll go with your ratings. I also remembered one more
ratings.
Song you can watch if you like the similar topic. Flogging Molly song reacted to If I Could Ever Leave This World Alive.
Okay, you can listen to it,
yeah.
Listen to it, yeah.
Listen to that song too. I guess, if I'm not wrong, it was requested by David B.
Okay, you can listen to
that
song.
That's why I remember, yeah.
Flogging Molly, If I
Could Ever Leave This World Alive.
Just type it on YouTube and listen to it, because Kirti is always spot on about some things.
I remember the references that we have listened to give you another one, just in case you like.
That's it for this one.
Thank you for watching.
Check out our Patreon page to learn more about us. Life is too short. Definitely is.